I really like the way it looks. It's a grey container with windows, so you may not really pay much attention to it when you get into the hospital compound. In 2019, when we started, we were really like a baby.
In summary, you count whatever cells you get in all these four areas.
My name is Tabitha Chepkon. I work with AMPATH under the Global Health Institute. I work under Dr. Wendy O'Meara as a lab scientist and also a research assistant. I work under Pearl as a lab tech. Some of the experiments really took time because we had to do a lot of troubleshooting here and there. Sometimes they really work so well. Sometimes you fail. But I think at this point we are somewhere.
My name is Linda Maraga. Microscopy training skills is the first mandate that this lab was built for. We wanted a situation where we would be able to get the lab techs from peripheral facilities, maybe health centers and sub-county hospitals, and then just train them and build up their capacity in terms of microscopy work. In most of these facilities, they do not have sophisticated machines, but all levels of laboratories have what we call a microscope. And so we wanted to make this microscope to be very useful to this individual who is at that point of care.
But now,
can't you use a slide?
I'm Wendy O'Meara. I'm an associate professor of medicine and global health at Duke University, and I'm seconded here at Moi University as a visiting lecturer. I've been in Kenya since 2007, and so for about 15 years I was full-time here in Kenya. More recently I've started to split my time a little bit more between Duke and Kenya, but this is still home. Down at the health centers, the small community health facilities, we really saw that all of these facilities have the microscope and the technical ability to use that microscope. Can we help them expand the repertoire of tests that they can do with that microscope? Can we help them make this microscope a much more powerful tool in that healthcare setting? They don't have hemocytometers and they don't have access to a lot of the equipment, that biochemistry and those things that we kind of take for granted in less resource-constrained settings. But they do have this very effective and powerful tool, and it's just a matter of teaching them a few additional techniques that they can do, and we can understand better how to treat the patient. PEARL stands for Partnership in Education and Research Laboratory. And we really we picked that name because we wanted to just clearly distinguish it from a clinical laboratory. You know, we're here to enhance this partnership and to enhance the what this hospital can do in this community by adding this research and training component. There's a team of three Moi lecturers, specialists, and myself, and we've come together and put together a curriculum. We organized it into a one-week workshop or training session where we tried to divide the time equally between didactic and practical sessions, hands-on time in the lab. These faculty members at Moi, they teach medical students, they practice clinically in, you know, one of two national level referral hospitals in this country, but they were really passionate about taking some of those skills and bringing them to these clinicians and these lab techs who are serving in these rural communities.
Once you see this, you can scan using power 10, then quickly go to power 40, then now quantify.
For field work, as far as entomology work is concerned, it needs a lot of perseverance. Mosquitoes like to hide in very dark places within the house. I'm Evans Omondi Omolo, and I work with the Duke University as an assistant entomologist. Most of the vector-borne diseases are becoming problematic, that is globally. My interest is to serve the public, and I really want to know how the vector itself behaves. Eradicating them isn't easy. The core objective of this study is to track the infection at the household level. We use the Procopac technique, which uses the negative pressure. So this created the suction, which enables us to collect the mosquitoes. You connect your battery, and then you start aspirating. Most of the symptoms that present themselves are the fever and the headache. That is the most common. I was told like the child was suffering from malaria. The mother told me that he had been complaining of fever and the headache. I tested and simply prescribed her the dosage required. Of course, the study pays for that. I'm so much interested to know how it behaves and what are the best control strategies that can be employed to actually deal away with the malaria completely.